Thank you for joining me on Coffee With. To say that I am out of my element is certainly an understatement. We're at the Coral Room at the Vicksburg Hotel, and this weekend is going to be the production of Rocky Horror Picture Show, in case you weren't able to guess. And we're here on stage with a group. Let's try that again.
Okay.
And we're here. We're not cutting that.
Okay.
And we're here.
Do you want me to be quiet this time?
With,
sorry.
No, I want to hear you.
Okay.
Or maybe we will edit that.
No.
We're a rowdy bunch.
We'll prove it.
We're not that at all.
Prove it. So anyway, we're at the Coral Room, and somebody convinced me, I don't know what I was thinking really, to dress like this.
Your reputation.
Where is Jack?
Hiding.
Yeah. Jack needs to be hidden because I've seen him tonight. So here's a group of
Transylvania.
I'm a little scared.
You don't need to be scared of us. It's the rest of the cast you need to fear. We're just here for the party.
Oh, but I've interviewed you before.
Get my crazy eyes on.
Get your crazy eyes on.
Hey, so, Christina, wait a minute. What's your line?
That's funny!
Oh, my! Jack, what are you doing?
He's going to set me on fire is what he's going to do.
Okay, so... without ruining the story and the fog, tell us a little bit about the story.
Well, poor Janet and Brad are traveling back from a wedding, and they happen upon a little mansion tucked off in the woods. And you would think it would be just kind of a calm little mansion hiding away in the woods, but it's not. It's really an interesting little midnight party going on. And poor straight-laced Brad and Janet don't know what to do with themselves.
Okay.
And we're party guests.
Oh, y'all are guests.
Yeah. Y'all watch it all unfold. Except for Dr. Scott there.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And what is Dr. Scott doing?
Well, Dr. Scott,
I am a science teacher at Denton High, and I was just happening to be wandering around, and I saw this castle, and I thought I should probably check it out.
Do we have him mic'd?
No, but I can hear it.
Okay. Stacy, tell me what happens next.
When they hit the house, when they get to the castle?
Hey, look.
Well, Frankenfurter takes them up to the lab.
And that's where we are right
that's
now,
where
right?
We are right
we're
now.
In the lab.
And we're fixing to meet Rocky and Eddie.
Okay. And then if they want to know the rest of the story.
Oh, they have to show up.
They have to show up.
Yeah.
And when should they show up?
Well, we've got several shows beginning this coming Friday. We've got a 7:30 show, and then on Saturday we have a 7:30 show and a 10:30 show. And we're going to do the same thing the following weekend, Friday 7:30, and then two shows on Saturday, 7:30 and 10:30. And then, of course, we have the Halloween show, which is midnight on Halloween. We will have a party beforehand about 10 o'clock. We're going to have a knockdown Halloween party, and every night that they come to a show, there is a $100 costume contest for the best Rocky costume. I mean, you could come in costume. We encourage everybody to come in costume, but the $100 is for the best Rocky costume.
Okay, now,
character.
Rocky Horror came out. I'm way older than all of y'all here. I remember this when I was in college, and we used to make our toast and get our umbrellas and do all this and go to the theater, right? Do you want people to come prepared in that way?
Absolutely. We will sell prop kits at the door, and some people do bring their own props, but the props for the play are a little bit different than the props for the movie.
Okay.
There's no toast in the play. So we will have prop kits. I think they're $2, and they come with everything you need.
$3.
They come with everything you need.
Okay. We probably should say, although I hope people would assume this from the costumes, this is an adult performance.
Yeah.
This would not be a night that you would want to haul your children down here for a family night out.
Absolutely not.
No one under 17 will be allowed in.
There you go.
It's different than the movie. So the things you will yell are a little bit different than if you go see the movie, because not all the same scenes are in the live action 3D play. But we encourage you to yell. We encourage you to get creative. We've had some interesting new lines. I know people are pretty proud of the new lines that they can come up with to yell at us. And we try not to get too flustered by all the stuff people will yell, but we encourage as much audience participation as possible.
How many people are in the cast?
Fluctuates.
It depends on who can show up and just be almost half naked.
Yeah, we'll take you. And you'd be amazed how many people do just show up in their underwear and want to be part of the cast.
That's how I really don't even want to. No, once I saw Jack, I was just, you know, I think he enjoys
any
this.
Excuse.
Yes, yeah. I can tell. Yeah, he let me borrow his shoes.
They're awesome.
Hold on, I gotta get a shot of the shoes.
I love the shoes. And if I could say the name of where I work, that's what color they are. But they're fine shoes, Jack. Thanks for loaning them to me.
You're welcome.
The first time you probably ever borrowed a pair of stiletto platform heels from a guy, right?
From anyone, actually, but yes.
Definitely a guy.
Absolutely.
Never saw that coming.
This is my first time to have any shoes like this on. Is this something y'all do every year?
Sometimes several times.
Y'all don't do it just at Halloween?
Last year we did it Halloween and New Year's. Our plan this year is to just do it at Halloween.
Yeah.
As much as a fun show it is, we've got other stuff we want to work on. So, you know, but we do it, our hope is to do it every Halloween because it's just such a great show to be involved in and people like to show up for it.
Now, how many of y'all have been in this production before? Okay, that's almost everybody. Do you always play the same character?
Yeah.
Yes. Yep.
You do. Why?
Why not?
It's fun.
Because.
It's easier than learning new
yeah.
lines.
Yeah, you don't have to learn a bunch of new stuff. Well, obviously, y'all have a lot of fun doing this. Mm-hmm. Yeah. You have to get a shot of her eyelashes, Chris. She put my makeup on me, and I wanted her eyelashes.
Maybe we should do like a tranny roll call.
Sure. Yeah, why don't you tell us everybody's name? Oh, well, they're not mine.
Shout them out.
Dr.
I'm
Scott.
Carolyn, or Transylvania, number 17.
Transylvania, number 17.
Sure,
Sarah.
I'm Sarah without number.
Sarah without number? Mm-hmm. You're just a generic Transylvanian?
9.
You just made that up.
Oh, it should be Yoga. Amber Fender.
Ralph Shenzhen. That roll call wasn't that much fun. Kristen.
Kristen.
Transylvanian.
37.
There you go.
Yeah, mine's 9.
Jessica, Transylvanian.
40.
Jessica, Transylvanian, 40.
Dr. Scott.
Dr. Scott.
Josh, Transylvanian, number 6.
Josh, Transylvanian, number 7. I love the blue hair.
The only male Transylvanian.
Yeah.
Highly outnumbered.
I'm Stacy, Transylvanian, number 13.
And I'm Christina, Transylvania number 135. And I'm also the usherette.
And just for the heck of it, let me just see your crazy eyes.
I never understood them before, so I don't know what to do. I just
well,
did them,
understood
didn't
it
I?
When I interviewed you before the other, what was that show?
I love you, perfect.
Well, but I never knew what you said I did.
Well, but you said that your husband told you what you did.
Wait a minute, I want to get a close-up of that.
You called them something else, but I called them your kooky eyes.
Oh.
You have kooky eyes.
You know what? You dug a hole the first time. I think it's getting deeper. What are you talking about?
Hit your line.
But now we could call them kooky Transylvanian eyes.
Sure.
Right.
Sure.
Right.
We're alien. That's how it goes.
Well, everybody needs to come out and see this.
Absolutely.
For sure.
And get your tickets now before it sells out.
Yes. This is a fairly small theater.
Yes.
And you don't want to miss it. So, to what number do we need to call?
601-636-8313. We're puppets. His hand is up my butt. You can't tell.
Oh, we have a new guest.
Come on, trainees. It's star time. Let's go. We'll be right back.
Promotional consideration provided by
Amber Sanders from Happy Hair. Get your hair happy at 3402 Wisconsin Avenue.